what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is think of me and I peace of mind.
Hey Skyline, my name is Blake Lees.
And I'm Ryan Anderson, and welcome back to another week of SPTV.
Let's hop right into some announcements. This week was Counselor Appreciation Week. If you haven't already, thank your counselor for everything they have done this school year.
Spring sports registration ends on February 15th. If you're planning on participating, be sure to get your forms in.
And just to clarify, track is not a cut sport. Not a cut sport. Sorry for the misinformation last week.
That's it for announcements. If you'd like to share a school announcement on the show, email us at sptvspartans@gmail.com.
Dude, have you heard? A terrible plague has passed through the school.
The disease has spread swiftly and ruthlessly, leaving no one without suffering.
Over a third of our student body has perished so far.
I've heard it has a case fatality rate higher than the bubonic plague.
And more infectious than tuberculosis.
Many students of the class of 2018 are falling victim to this terrible illness. Hold on. This just in, we have an update from our Center of Disease Control Specialist, Thomas DeBow, reporting on this deadly infection. Tommy?
Hello, Skyline. I'm Tommy DeBow with breaking news. I'm here in the halls right now, and something else has begun to occupy the bright young minds of Skyline High School now that finals have passed. And no, it's not the Tide Pod Challenge. It's senioritis.
So can you just tell me what you know about senioritis?
I know that around the second semester, a lot of seniors seem to think they're done.
Yeah, it's become a real epidemic. 72% of our seniors have come down with senioritis, and they're tired, they're sluggish. A ton of my seniors talk about Fortnite all the time. They need to get their act together.
So you contracted it?
Yeah.
Can you tell me about the contraction process?
It was late at night. We were at a party and then we just stopped caring.
You can't be. Have you or any loved ones been affected by senioritis?
Yes.
Before I knew it.
Ugh.
Chris.
Ooh.
Chris.
Ooh. Vicky. Chris. Do you know what senioritis is?
I know a little bit about it.
What if I told you that your symptoms are showing signs that you have stage 3 senioritis?
I wouldn't really care.
As you can see, it's the first day of second semester. There's not a single senior working in the library.
Hello, can you please state your name? Have you started to see signs or symptoms of senioritis in the hallways?
Yeah, it's really contagious. I see death everywhere. Just bodies, that's all I see.
He sees dead people.
Hey, are you gonna pay for that?
Talk to the hand.
I'm pregnant.
Get to the chopper!
It's not a tumor at all.
No more Mr. Kimble to go to the bathroom. Nothing. There is no bathroom.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Mmm. Oh, these cookies.
Put that cookie down! Now!
Leave anything for us?
Just bodies.
Get to the chopper!
Get to the chopper!
Get down!
Get to the chopper! Every time I get the pump!
Every time I get the pump, it feels like...
Hasta la vista, baby!
Get me to the chopper!
Get to the chopper!
I'll be back!
How about that Super Bowl, Blake?
All I can say is fly, Eagles, fly.
I always knew Nick Foles-Sylvania had it in him.
Speaking of sports, let's send it over to Carter for an update on all the hard work our winter sports athletes have been putting in.
Hey Skyline, I'm Carter Culver. I hope you all had a good week and I'm back with an update on winter sports.
Wrestling competed in the Kinko 4A Championship this weekend. Kenta Desti placed first in the 113 weight class, Cole Turner first, and Maximilian Huff second in the 120 weight class, Jacob Benton third, and Aiden Cohn fifth in the 145 weight class. Nathan Delia placed fourth in the 152 weight class, and Nick Beattie first in the 195 weight class. Ben Kubicki third in the 220 weight class, and Michael Ose third for the 285 weight class. Gymnastics competed in the 4A Kinko Championship at Mercer Islands High School this weekend and killed it. The following girls will all be moving on to districts. Shelby Ludecker and Emma Scone for floor, Corinne Hack for vault, Caitlin Roper for bars and beam, along with Lisa Zhao and Anna Olson for vault, bars, beam, and floor. Way to go, girls, and keep up the great work. Good luck at districts. Boys Swim and Dive had the best performance at Kinko in school history, placing second overall and first in the 4A division. The 200 medley relay of Sam Schaff, Jeremy Kim, Willow Daffer, and Colin Hun set a new Kinko record. Willow Daffer took second place in the 200-yard freestyle and first in the 500 freestyle. Colin Hun took third place in the 100-yard butterfly. The 200-yard freestyle relay of Juice Christopholis, Sam Schaff, Joe Spaniak, and Colin Hun took third. Colin Hun won first place and set a new Skyline record in the 100-yard breaststroke. And the 400-yard freestyle relay team of James Zhang, Jeremy Kim, Juice Christopholis, and Willow Daffer took third. Congrats, boys. Keep up the great work and good luck this weekend at Merriweight Pool in Mercer Island for the 4A Seeking District Swim Meet. Girls basketball beat Inglemore Friday 89-77 with Jade LaVille scoring 54 points, breaking her own school record. They won their final game of the regular season Tuesday against North Creek. This week, Morgan Jones caught up with Skyline's record holder, Jade LaVille.
Jade LaVille has had a basketball in her hands since before she can remember. Her passion for the game is evident in the school record she has set over her four-year varsity career here at Skyline.
When I stepped on that court, I knew for sure that was a sport I wanted to focus on.
Jade was born to be a basketball player. Just, that's it. She was born to play basketball. She's been doing it since she was a kid. And at a very young age, I think everybody that watched her knew that she was going to be something special.
And we went undefeated every year in rec basketball because she was the only player that knew how to do a lay-in at like six. So she would just run up and down the court and score on people all game long.
Jade has continued to work hard and play at a higher level than ever before.
This season I feel like is my best season personally. I'm just really comfortable on the court and having the teammates that I have this year and the coaches that I have this year have really helped me prosper.
She has broken every single scoring record that Skyline has, which are points in a season, points in a game, averages, three-pointers.
However, her play on the court is heavily influenced by her personality and dedication off the court.
And I think I've talked about it before, but she comes to practice every day, and then after practice, she goes to the gym to shoot more, to lift. She's constantly working on her game, and that's one of the reasons that she's achieved so many of her goals.
Not only is Jade such a dominant player on the court, which I think everyone knows, but off the court she's so fun and she's such a caring person, and I can't imagine like our season without her.
Last year, Jade committed to play Division I basketball at Boise State University.
My plans for Boise State are just to make an impact early, show my coaches there and my teammates there why I'm there, and just do what I can.
Before she focuses on the next level, Jade and the rest of the Skyline program have set goals for the upcoming postseason.
Our team goals are to get to state, no doubt. We've worked so hard, that's been our goal since the season started. So we just want to get to state and show Skyline that what we've been doing. We play Issaquah at home tonight at 7 o'clock as our first playoff game. I'd love for you guys to come out and support.
Don't worry, for those of you that haven't seen her play yet, the girls will be starting off the postseason tonight at 6 at home against Issaquah. So be sure to come out and support them as they look to beat the Eagles for the third time this year. Boys basketball also beat Inglemore on Friday 61-47. They had their final game of the regular season Tuesday night, beating North Creek 58-45, as they have their first game of the postseason after having a bye today. A special shout out to dance for competing this weekend at Kent Ridge High School in a huge competition where they placed first in dance, second in palm, and second in kick. Way to go, girls, keep up the great work. And good luck to cheer this week at Nationals down in Florida. This year has been Skyline's biggest class of commits for sports ever, with 20 athletes committing to schools. Congrats to the following athletes who committed and signed on this past Wednesday. Congrats to Taylor Junkie for softball at Stony Brook University, Kara Harnick for softball at Babson College, Shayna Swanson for softball at Howard University, Geneva Schlepp for track and cross country at Wazoo, Connor Edson for track and cross country at Colorado School of Mines, Griffin Gans for cross country at Colorado State University, Rebecca Owen for volleyball at University of Idaho, Will Carson for lacrosse at Boston University, Logan McCurlick for rowing at UW, Aaron Shea for fencing at Air Force Academy, Drew Tenzar for baseball at Pacific University, Jade LaBille for basketball at Boise State, Matthew Sindrick for football at Cal Berkeley, Evan Alexander for football at Colorado School of Mines, Lucas Richardson for soccer at Western, Anna Smith for soccer at USC, Ava Giovanola for soccer at SPU, Mariah Alexander for soccer at SPU, Marissa Carpenter for soccer at University of the Pacific, and Emma Reuter for soccer at LMU.
This is a record amount of commits for Skyline High School. Way to go, class of 2018. We the best.
That's all I've got for this week. I'll see you all next week. Back to you, Blake and Randy.
Never gets old.
Hey, you remember Chase? I really miss that guy.
I heard he was in Sky Comish skinning rabbits or something.
I think he actually was. Welcome back to another installment of DIY with Chase.
Hello, everybody. I'm Chase, and I'm going to show you how to change the oils on y'all's cars.
DIY with Chase.
You need your oil, filter, your wrench, and your air cleaner, and your drip pan. First step, you need a car to change the oil in. Second step, pop the hood. And in this case, it's already popped. All right, third step, check your dipstick. See? Oh, no bueno. And you see there? If it's low, you need to add a quart, just like that. So you stumbled under the car, you found the drain plug, and now let's put some light on the subject. So make sure your pan's aligned with where your drip is, and you just loosen it off. So in this case, the filter's already off, but it should usually be hand tight. If it's not, get an oil filter wrench and just, you know, loosen it up and then screw it off. It might come off over your hands like this. That's why you wear gloves or wear something that you don't like. Not your ex-boyfriend or something, but yeah, and then it's done. Get your fresh oil and you're pouring it in. You pour it where it says put oil in here and you put it in it to the right amount that your car needs. And then when it needs it and it has it, then you're done. Thing is, when you're done, check the levels. And if they're right, you're done.
Thanks, Skinner. Now I know how to change my oil.
If you need any more motivation to see our theater's rendition of The Great Gatsby, here's a quick video highlighting the event.
It's up to you, New York, New York.
Yeah, I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I'm most definitely from
New York. Hey. Uh-huh. I'm sweet young, yeah. With dreams of fame. There's nothing you can do. Yeah. Now you're New York. Uh-huh. 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 These streets will make you feel brand new. New. The lights will inspire you.
Come on.
Let's hear it.
You welcome, OG.
New York. New York. Yeah. New
I made you hot, nigga. Catch me at the X with OG.
Do your best to check out the play this weekend.
Tickets are $4 with an ASB card and $8 without.
I heard it's going to be a great show.
And let's wish a happy birthday to Mr. Smith.
And Mr. Meichler.
That's all for this show.
Have a great weekend, Spartans.